It may be noted that the readings observed by this voltmeter is line voltage. So here we need to substitute phase voltage, hence we need to divide this reading by root 3 for this star connection, as for this connection phase voltage is equal to line voltage by root 3, whereas phase current and line currents are equal. So take care of that. We may further observe that for this case, case 1, when axis of phi A, that is rotating magnetic field, aligns with D axis, at this moment the flux linkage to the rotor field winding is maximum, but the flux cut by field winding conductors is zero at this moment. See here, this is cross sectional view, cylindrical in shape, so the conductors are like this and field flux are like this, so no field flux is being cut by any of the conductor, hence at this moment flux linkage is maximum, but rate of cutting the flux by these field winding conductors is zero. Hence EMF induced measured by this voltmeter is zero at this moment, case 1, just remember it. What about case 2? When axis of phi A, rotating magnetic field, aligns with Q axis, at this moment of time the rate of cutting the flux, armature flux, by field winding conductors is maximum. As we can observe, this field is rotating at constant speed ns, so at this moment d phi by dt will be maximum. That can be sensed, observed with the help of this voltmeter. So there will be a range of this voltmeter reading between minimum and maximum. Minimum will be 0 when the axis of phi A is aligning along d axis. So let us write, that is giving 0, and then along q axis it is giving some maximum, then again some 0. Fine. So let us take T here, and this Vf, let us say V or Vf, Vf, better write Vf, this reading as Vf, voltage across open circuited field winding terminals. So this is corresponding to D axis and this is corresponding to Q axis. Let us write here Q axis. Again along D axis, again along D axis, this will give 0 voltage drop. So write here D axis, again here Q axis, and D axis, here also D axis, Q axis, and so on. What will be frequency of this wave? As we know that the relative speed of this rotating field with respect to field winding conductors is ns minus nr. So percentage slip will be ns minus nr upon ns. That is known as slip, percentage slip into 100, 100%. If supply frequency is f, then the frequency of this induced EMF in field winding conductors will be sf, sf, right here sf. For example, if we have maintained slip of 2% and supply frequency is 50 hertz, so 2% of 50, that is 1 hertz. So 1 hertz means 1 cycle per second. So the this one cycle corresponds to 1 second. If we represent in time second, so this represents time interval of 1 second. But for f is equal to 50, we have 50 such cycles of supply in 1 second, that is 50 hertz. That's why we are maintaining this slip as low as possible, so that the readings corresponding to this variation in VF or this voltmeter or ammeter can be easily observed by a person. If this frequency will be very high, then it will be very difficult to take the readings, which are changing from minimum to maximum. Here also we have discussed, when this axis is aligning along the axis, then these readings and these readings corresponding to the various cases. So if we are using oscilloscope instead of voltmeter and ammeter to avoid errors involved with this instruments due to inertia effect, if we will use oscilloscope, so the oscillogram will be like this. Oscillogram is basically a record created by oscilloscope. The record produced by oscilloscope is known as oscillogram. So before that, for case 1, which is corresponding to D axis, we know that IA is minimum. So IA is fluctuating between minimum and some maximum value. Corresponding to this Q axis, this case, when phi A axis is aligning along Q axis, IA is maximum. So corresponding to this, IA will be having some maximum value. Again, corresponding to D axis, minimum value. Again, corresponding to Q axis, maximum value. Again, corresponding to this is D axis, minimum value. So it will be having minimum here, right? Like this. So variation in IA, armature current, we may write armature current IA will be like this. So that can be observed with the help of this ammeter. So take mirror image of this wave, this shape. So again, between some minimum and maximum magnitude, here minimum, here maximum, magnitude wise I am talking minimum, maximum magnitude, distance from this line minimum. So mirror image will be something like this. So under this envelope, if we want to show the current wave shapes, which is not possible to draw for 50 hertz supply, 50 cycles within this. So as a representative case, don't count these cycles. This is much, much lesser than the actual one, but it will be something like this. The frequency of this red colored waves will be having same as supply frequency, 50 cycles per second. So for 1 second, this variation in IA is also periodic. We can see that the same nature is repeated from here. So we may say that this variation is also a cyclic variation, having its frequency twice of this frequency of this VF. So in 1 second, we are having one cycle for 2% slip having supply frequency of 50 hertz. Then we will have two cycles of this variation in IA observed by this ammeter. So how is it difficult to observe two such cyclic readings in 1 second? 1 second. That's why we need to keep the slip as low as possible. Similarly, दिस इज आर्मेचर करंट. ओके रिटन ऑलरेडी रिटन हियर आई ए, वी मे राइट आई ए. सिमिलरली इफ वी वॉन्ट टू ड्रॉ प्लॉट ऑसिलोग्राम फॉर दिस रीडिंग आर्मेचर वोल्टेज ड्रॉप, देन फॉर दिस केस वी इज मैक्सिमम. सो फर्स्ट मार्क वन पॉइंट हियर, वन मैक्सिमम पॉइंट हियर, हियर ऑल्सो. सो फॉर डी एक्सिस वी हैव वी एज मैक्सिमम, कॉरस्पॉन्डिंग टू क्यू एक्सिस वी हैव मिनिमम, अगेन डी एक्सिस मैक्सिमम, क्यू एक्सिस मिनिमम एंड अगेन डी एक्सिस मैक्सिमम. सो एनवेलप विल बी समथिंग लाइक दिस. टेक मिरर इमेज. सो मैक्सिमम देन मिनिमम, मिनिमम मैक्सिमम लाइक दिस. दिस इज अगेन टी, दिस इज टी, दिस इज वी आर्मेचर टर्मिनल वोल्टेज. सो फॉर दिस वी मे प्लॉट द साइक्लिक वेरिएशन इन वोल्टेजेस लाइक दिस. सो दिस वोल्टमीटर रीडिंग विल फ्लक्चुएट बिटवीन मैक्सिमम मिनिमम वैल्यूज बिटवीन दिस वी मैक्स वी मीन लाइक दैट. एंड दिस इज द ऑसिलोग्राम प्रोड्यूस्ड बाय ऑसिलोस्कोप यूज्ड इंस्टेड ऑफ वोल्टमीटर एंड एमीटर सेटअप. फाइन. फर्दर देयर माइट बी एरर इन ऑब्जर्विंग द रीडिंग्स फ्रॉम ऑसिलोग्राम. सो इंस्टेड ऑफ इवैल्यूएटिंग जेड डी एंड जेड क्यू, जेड क्यू एंड जेड डी, इफ वी विल इवैल्यूएट जेड डी अपॉन जेड क्यू, देन द एरर्स वेदर ड्यू टू इनर्शिया इफेक्ट इन्वॉल्व विद दिस सेटअप वोल्टमीटर एंड एमीटर सेटअप और एरर इन ऑब्जॉर्बिंग द रीडिंग विद द हेल्प ऑफ ऑसिलोग्राम दैट विल बी नलिफाइड. सो फॉर मोर एक्यूरेट रिजल्ट इंस्टेड ऑफ डायरेक्टली इवेल्युएटिंग जेड डी एंड जेड क्यू वी विल इवेल्युएट जेड डी एंड जेड क्यू, रेशियो ऑफ जेड डी एंड जेड क्यू, एंड देन विद द हेल्प ऑफ ओपन सर्किट टेस्ट एंड शॉर्ट सर्किट टेस्ट डिस्कस्ड इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर इन सिंक्रोनस इम्पीडेंस मेथड वेयर वी डिस्कस वोल्टेज रेगुलेशन बाई सिंक्रोनस इम्पीडेंस मेथड. सो बाई परफॉर्मिंग दीज टू टेस्ट वी कैन गेट जेड डी एंड वंस दीज टू रेशियो ऑफ जेड डी एंड जेड क्यू एंड जेड डी आर नोन, जेड डी एंड जेड क्यू बोथ कैन बी, जेड डी इज नोन देन जेड क्यू कैन बी इवेल्युएटेड विद द हेल्प ऑफ दीज टू रीडिंग्स एंड देन एक्स टी मे बी इवेल्युएटेड using this formula ZD square minus under root ZD square minus RA square and XQ may be evaluated under root ZQ square minus RA square for more accuracy. Thank you very much. If still you have any doubt, feel free to ask me.